Hello students, this is Vishnu sir here. Today we'll be discussing about a very interesting topic in botany, and that is wonders of the plant kingdom. All of you must be wondering, what is there in plants? It's all green in color, it's around there everywhere, but if you look at them deeply, you will come across certain wonders which you have never thought about. Let us discuss about some of them. Though there are too many such wonderful plants in the world, here in this video we are going to discuss about three interesting ones which you may not have heard before. Can you guess what you can there see there in this slide? See the first picture. Don't you think this is a very unique and a weird looking tree? Let us look at some of them. Going to the first one. Have you heard about Rafflesia arnoldi? Yes, if you have guessed it right, this is the flower which is the largest in size in the plant kingdom. See how massive looking it is. And the name Rafflesia arnoldi, belonging to the family Rafflesiaceae, has come from the one who discovered it for the first time in 1818. His name was Sir Stamford Raffles, and upon looking at this flower for the first time, he described it by giving a statement: "It is perhaps the largest and the most magnificent flower in the world." And along with him, there was a companion whose name was Dr. James Arnold. So the name is Rafflesia arnoldi. Talking about this plant, you'll be surprised to know, though it has got the largest flower in the plant kingdom, but this plant surprisingly has no roots, no stem, no leaves. This is simply a jungle parasite, common in the not very common, but it is present in the forests of Southeast Asia and occurs as a parasite. This is actually on the verge of extinction. Another interesting feature about this plant is that when the bud opens, you cannot bear the smell. It has got a very awful odor, but it is of an advantage to the plant. Because of the awful odor, it is able to attract carrion flies and such insects towards it, which happens to pollinate the plant. Other beautiful flowers have very good fragrance, which can attract other insects like honeybees, butterflies and all, but this plant has devised a new method of attracting insects and ensuring pollination. See, as it is written out here, it takes about 9 months for the flower to bloom, and it can last for only a week. And the weight of a fully grown flower is about 7 kilograms. So it is a parasite which grows on a host called the Tetrasigma vine, belonging to the grape family. So, have you understood about this unique plant wonder? Let us move on to the next one. Have you heard about something called carnivorous plant? Normally, plants are considered as producers, right? Because they have their own green leaves, they can carry out photosynthesis, and they can produce their own food. But there are plants like this Venus flytrap, which has its own green leaves, can carry out photosynthesis, but at the same time it has got a taste for some new varieties as well. This is the Venus flytrap, called as the Dionaea muscipula, belonging to the family Droseraceae. And as you can see in this picture, it has got very different unique modified leaves, at the edges of which you can see there are sharp teeth like projections. Inside this trap, this brightly pink colored structure which can attract the insects, and attraction is the first step towards death. Insects get attracted, they come and explore. In the meantime, what happens is, inside this pink colored trap there are very tiny hairs which are present. Those hairs, when they are kicked by the insect, it's a trigger, And as soon as the trigger starts, another kick and the trap will snap shut in about half a second. And one such trap can digest about 3 to 4 insects. And for complete digestion, about 10 days are required, after which the leaf reopens. So like this, there are many such interesting other carnivorous plants also. You can find out yourself and see their uniqueness. Along with insects, it has been reported that rodents or even small animals like frogs can also trap inside. You can see this small animation. See how the frog has got shut. Moving to the last one, Adansonia. Now this is a huge tree, but the tree has got a very weird look. It is a strange looking tree bearing the thickest trunk in the world. See this. Very weird ones found in the deserts, and it has got a huge trunk which can store a very large amount of water in it. This tree, Adansonia digitata, has come from the name of the person, a botanist called Adanson, and the word digitata stands for finger-like. As you can see in the shape of its leaf, it has got finger-like palmate structure. It is also called, there are different names to it, it's also called as the monkey bread tree or the baobab tree found in Africa. In English it is also called Gorakchinch. Sorry, in India it is also called the Gorakchinch or Gorakamali. Normally it is a deciduous one and has got leaves on it for 3 months of the year. Rest of the time it is leafless, but it has got bright white colored bulbous flowers on it, and they are pollinated by bats. The trunk is very huge, and it has been reported to reach a girth of about 30 meter in Africa. And you can imagine that by you can imagine that by 14 to 15 tall men spreading their arms fully who can encircle this tree. So this is a very very unique tree. See, it is given, and the one which was discovered by Adanson himself was so large that it was more than 5,000 years old, and there were visitors in that time who had carved the names on the trunk belonging to the 14th or the 15th century, and even in 18th century they were still growing. See this, a massive one, a large trunk, almost like a small independent house we can say. Very weird one. And in some parts of Africa, because of the unique appearance of the tree, the local tribals, what they do is they bury the dead bodies of such quacks or witch doctors, and they, because of the internal heat of the tree, these bodies, they become dry and mummified without any further treatment. So it's very eerie, don't you think so? So we come to the end of this session. Find out more such interesting plants in the nature. Keep exploring, you never know what surprises the plants can show you, and you will get fascinated with it. Thanks a lot.